I'm Colin Firth and I am apparently what is known as an Oxfam ambassador. Oxfam are an international agency who work to find lasting solutions to the problem of global poverty. Their work is critical in combating the misery caused by corrupt governments, conflict, natural disasters, and unfair trade rules. So please support them.
I love coffee, I love tea, I love the Java Jive and it loves me. Coffee and tea and the Java and me. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, boy. I love Java, sweet and hot. Whoops, Mr. Moto, I'm a coffee pot. Shoot me the pot, now pour me a shot. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup. Oh, slip me a slug from the wonderful mug. I've got a rug till I'm stuck in the jug. A slice of onion and a raw one. Raw one. Waiter, waiter, percolator. I love coffee, I love tea. I love the Java Jive and it loves me. Coffee and tea and the Java and me. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup. Oh, Boston beans, soybeans, yeah. Green beans, cabbage and greens.
Oh, cook it.
I'm not keen upon a bean, unless it is a cheery, cheery bean, boy. I love coffee, I love tea. I love the Java Jive and it loves me. Coffee and the tea and the Java and me. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, yeah. I love Java, sweet and hot. Whoops, Mr. Moto, I'm a coffee pot. Shoot me the pot, now pour me a shot. A cup, a cup, a cup.
Yeah.
Oh, throw me that slug from the wonderful mug. I'll cut a rug till I'm snug in the jug. Drop a nickel in the pot, Joe. I take 'em a slow. Waiter, waiter, percolator. I love coffee, I love tea. I love the Java Jive and it loves me. Coffee and tea and the Java and me.
Yeah.
A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup. Boom.
When I visited the farmers in Ethiopia, I felt a strong sense of being an imposter. You know, why am I here? Am I a voyeur?
Right.
Am I sort of poverty tourist? And I felt I had to have something to say for myself to explain my presence. I wasn't going to help them financially. I just wasn't in a position to come in and change lives. Just these are farmer collectives, cooperatives. Yeah.
And what'd they tell you?
They basically said, please tell people on the streets in London and New York to pay a decent price for the coffee that we make. This was a difficult moment for me because I realized they didn't know how much we actually are paying on the street for a cup of coffee.
Right.
Because it's a lot.
It is a lot. It's just not getting back to them.
It's not. So someone's getting it.
Yeah.
And they hadn't realized. And when you buy your cappuccino at one of the high street cafes, you don't know that the coffee you're buying is actually worth incredibly little.
Right.
I mean, during the coffee crisis around the end of the last decade, the actual market value of coffee in the world went to pretty well zero.
Really?
Zero. I mean, the coffee you were buying here wasn't costing you anything differently.
It's all going into Mr. Starbucks.
Exactly, but the big multinationals, the big coffee roasters, were paying the farmers precisely what it was worth, which was zero.
Wow.
So, I mean, it was gangsterism, really, I think.
So now these smaller farms are able to at least get their product out there at a fair price?
Well, fair trade, you know, that you can take it onto different levels. It's not just about price, it's also about work standards and safety and workers' rights and all kinds of things,
right,
in order to qualify for the label.
Right.
Oh, throw me that slug from the wonderful mug. I'll cut a rug till I'm snug in the jug. Drop a nickel in the pot, Joe.
I take them a slow. Waiter, waiter, percolator. I love coffee, I love tea. I love the jabber jive and it loves me. Coffee and tea and the jabber and me.
Yeah.
A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup. Boom.